My name is Stefan Johansson. I'm a senior petroleum engineering major from Tulsa, Oklahoma. And I have the privilege of being the team lead on the technology commercialization team at CCM. The TechCom team works with the Ames National Laboratory at Iowa State University to develop a commercialization strategy for a nanopolishing slurry that is used to polish various surfaces to near atomically smooth levels. Very interesting stuff, but I will leave that for the rest of the team to talk about in the presentation. What I'd like to do now is to thank everyone for that Anthem project, Jeff, Sue, Susan, Melissa, and Cass. Thank you guys so much. Thanks for the work you guys have with direct input into our project. But thank you for all the time you take to teach us the problem solving and communication skills that are necessary to accomplish these great projects. Next, I'd like to move on to thanking our friends at the Ames National Laboratory and Iowa State University, starting off with our brilliant mentor, Dr. Yuko Demartiri, and his wonderful assistant and co-mentor, Marie Montoya. You guys were a pleasure working this semester, and you really have a great, great invention that has not just technical applications, but also real commercial applications. Thank you to Craig Foley, who works in the technology transfer office at Iowa State University. He's a mentor of ours, so thank you very much, Craig. And then a huge thank you to Todd Rogowski, that works at Ames National Laboratory. He wears many hats at Ames National Laboratory. We are still not quite sure exactly what he does, but it is a lot. And he was a wonderful, wonderful mentor to us. Your humor and care and everything about our project has found your way into a very special part of all of our hearts, not just on our team, but in each previous team throughout the last 6 years and those projects that we've had. So thank you, Todd. Now I'd like to thank the biggest part of our team, the wonderful people that are sitting behind me, Michael, Sean, Amanda, and Anna. Thank you guys tremendously for the work you guys have done this semester. I remember the night before I got there, when we kicked off this day, and I was kind of having trouble sleeping. I was so excited. And normally that's reserved for a game football game or something, but it happened. It was because I had such high expectations for the project. I was really looking forward to meeting. And looking back, it was kind of maybe a little bit unfair. It was a big expectation. I'm not going to live up to this. But standing up here now, after a great semester, I can truly say that they have outdone every expectation by such a wide margin. And I'm so appreciative that I was able to work with them last semester. Really good people, probably some of the smartest people I've ever had the privilege of working with. So thank you guys for that, it was awesome. And I guess even more so, I'm appreciative that CCW brought us all together and gave us the ability to make this great version of that. So that was great. So thank you guys tremendously. And without further ado, here is Team Ames.
Faster processors. In optical polishing, more smooth In pursuit of this perfect finish, both industries are using metal polishing. The current method for nano polishing involves two rotating surfaces with the target material called the wafer of the diode sandwiched in between. A key part of the system is the slurry, a solution like the one Ames has created, which is composed of a liquid phase, nanoparticles, and a stabilizer for the nanoparticles. This slurry basically acts like liquid sandpaper by draining the surface of the target material. And, like sandpaper, the finer the finish gets to be, the smaller the particles must be. Even with this specialized technology and decades of advancement in nanopolishing, both of these industries still seek improvements, incremental improvements in polishing and smoothness. The AIM slurry is able to provide us. In laboratory testing, the AIM slurry is capable of polishing stainless steel to 3 inch strength, whereas the industry representative control was only capable of polishing to 7. Along with this, the AIM slurry is capable of polishing smart substances such as tungsten carbon, which the industry representative control was unable to polish at all. This means that the AIM slurry not only provides smooth surfaces, but it can also be used for more applications. The key to this impressive performance is AIM's use of 3.5 nanometer zirconium particles, significantly smaller particles than are common in the industry today. This incredibly small particle size, coupled with the identical hardness of zirconium, is what allows the AIM slurry to outperform its.
Thanks, Sean. Over the course of this semester, we looked at 3 different market entry points for the AIM slurry, as well as the best opportunity for AIM to successfully commercialize their slurry, as well as to make the 3 following recommendations. Our first recommendation is to target the nanoparticle manufacturing industry, who will be able to produce the AIM slurry in industrial products. Our next recommendation is that AIM create or change the base from oil base to aqueous base, and then conduct market testing to prove finally, we recommend that AIM's license exclusively with a potential partner will bring us to the following these recommendations will allow AIM's to tap into $72.5 million. In order to understand where AIM's fits into this, let's examine the life cycle of the slurry. To begin with, nanoparticle manufacturers take in raw materials to produce base slurries. Base slurries are simply nanoparticles suspended in liquid colloidal with stabilizers. These base slurries, however, are not yet liquid. In order to make them liquid polishing, these base slurries are sold to slurry manufacturers. Slurry manufacturers take the base slurries and combine them with chemical additives. These chemical additives specifically tailor these polishing slurries to the exact stage and process of each object in this polishing. This means that each polishing slurry, while important, only impacts a small portion of the market. That's why I recommend that AIM's target the nanoparticle manufacturing industry. The nanoparticle manufacturing industry is already a great fit for our market, or for the AIM slurry, because we spoke with the CFO of Cabot Microelectronics, one of the world's largest slurry manufacturers. He told us that he thought our slurry met the description of a base slurry. We followed this up with additional research and additional industry interviews, and they could all recommend us. This means that AIM should be able to tap into multiple markets and multiple industries, rather than being confined to one small portion of the manufacturing process. Some of these markets can be broadly segmented non-polishing and polishing. Non-polishing include industries such as thermal insulation, or polishing industries include those like semiconductor and optical polishing, as Sean already mentioned, as well as smaller and niche markets like screens. The nanoparticle manufacturing industry also has some great potential for this industry. Examples of these include GE and Sanofi, which are large multinational corporations with significant resources and capital, which are needing to store user data. They also have a reputation for being innovative, willing to work with new partners to form collaborative relationships that bring new technologies to market, which is exactly what they need to look for. The global nanoparticle manufacturing market that aims is growing, is worth $304 million a year, and is growing at about 7%. Within that market, the story is covering a portion called liquid dispersed metal oxide, which are basically base slurries that we discussed with metal particles. This is where it's specifically within that, there are three main metal particle slurries that we're talking about. These are those that have their base in silica, ceria, and zirconia. These particles are chosen because they share certain similarities with the AIM story, with the AIM story and having them. These three segments are areas where the AIM story can take over part of the market if all goes well. Not the entire thing, but a reasonable amount. Overall, this segment of the market is worth 24%, or $72.5 million, which is exactly what AIM is doing. It allows AIM to make a significant financial and technical impact in multiple industries. Unfortunately, before we can do that, we need a technical solution. Here, tell us about that technical solution.
Thank you, Michael. In order for the AIM story to be commercially viable in the nanoparticle manufacturing industry, it will be necessary to change it to an aqueous phase. Currently, the AIM story consists of 20 nanoparticles that are coyly suspended in motor oil. However, after speaking with both the head of R&D at M&S, as well as the applications manager at Angus Corporation, it has become evident that the increased cost of ownership associated with the use of an oil base will mean it is difficult to commercialize the AIM story in its current state. This is due to both environmental and financial reasons. On the environmental end, the use of potentially harmful chemicals such as acetones in the cleaning process, as well as the logistics of disposing an oil-based slurry when the overwhelming majority of slurries used in nanopolishing consist of an aqueous base, would present cross-contamination concerns. On the financial end, the need to change the equipment used, as well as make the production line compatible with the use of an oil-based slurry, would mean a potential partner would incur a high cost that is otherwise unwilling to take on. Therefore, it is imperative for AIM to change its slurry to an aqueous phase. It can do this by finding a way to stabilize its depleted nanoparticles in an aqueous solution. There are two challenges associated with this. First, it is necessary for AIM to find a stabilizing agent that is capable of coyly suspending depleted nanoparticles. When we recently spoke to Dr. Ketta Martiri, he has already accomplished the first of the two-step process and is well on his way to accomplishing the second. Second, it will be necessary for AIM to test the new slurry on key materials such as copper, tungsten, aluminum, and silicon to demonstrate its superior performance compared to other competitive slurries. Once this is done and the change to the aqueous phase is made, it will be necessary for AIM to update its intellectual property. To do this, AIM must file a new provisional patent that reflects these technical changes. Thereafter, AIM will have 1 year in order to file a non-provisional patent in order to maintain rights over its intellectual property, as well as gain access to U.S. markets. In addition, after speaking to attorneys from firms such as Dunlap Cotting, we would also like to recommend that AIM files under the PCT in order to gain access to international markets. This is because many of the nanoparticle manufacturing companies who would be good potential partners for AIM are multinational corporations that are based abroad, and the only way for AIM to work with them while maintaining rights over its intellectual property is filing under the PCT. Therefore, after accomplishing these three main things, it will be possible for AIM to look into licensing its slurry to potential partners. To tell you more about how AIM should go about doing this, here's Amanda.
Thank you, Amanda. Once AIM updates its intellectual property, it will have a different patent right accessible to commercialize. AIM should pursue an exclusive license with ideally a large manufacturer. An exclusive license will allow AIM to maintain the rights to its intellectual property while partnering with a single license. This licensee agrees to take up the cost of the patent, both development and legal, in exchange for exclusive access to the intellectual property. commercial partners will attest the facility themselves and ensure commercial liability and industry events. We have already spoken to a number of very interested companies who have actually already requested sample state of the facility. This is the most important phase of the licensing agreement because potential partners and to test supersede AIDS. Once the nanoparticle manufacturers find commercial liability for the AIDS technology, they'll pursue the exclusive license of AIDS and their unique position upstream in the value chain.
Switching that is the
not teaching at the Institute. This specific slurry is a transient,
That is something that we currently don't know, because they haven't actually made this, they haven't finished the story. So that's unfortunately that's the work that you should say they are not quite complete yet, because they don't know the exact process and the exact materials that they're using.
Yes, this is a good question. Okay, so essentially it's a two-step process that is necessary to convert it to be Napier's case story. And the first step has already been accomplished. And he's already well on his way to accomplishing the second step. I'm not exactly sure when that'll be done, but he's very confident about getting that finished line.
Science, an exact science. So.
Time for one more question.